We have a very special guest today with us. They are literally the power couple. He's an actor and a politician and also a TV personality. She is called the Queen of Television, literally. Of course, a very, very noted, a very big actor and entrepreneur and now a politician. We are going to find out the work-life balance of the star couple and what is the secret of their happy married life as well. We love to welcome Mr. Sharad Kumar and Mrs. Radhika Sharad Kumar. Please. Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir. It's a pleasure having you on India Today. So we are going to start with one song dedicated for Radhika.
Oh, thank you.
Chitti, almost every household in Tamil Nadu was glued to television set after 9 p.m. for 2 years. And that was possible because of Chitti, right? Isn't it amazing? And Choti Ma, it was made as Choti Ma in Hindi as well.
Yes, it was. And it was Pinni in Telugu.
Pinni in Telugu. It's the most memorable. And still people call you as Chitti?
Yep.
Okay. Now, another song for Sir. Natamai, that's how Sharad is known as, right?
Yes, always.
Always. Do you call him Natamai at home? Natamai means village chief in Tamil. And that movie was like a huge success which ran for 176 days,
Natamai,
if I'm right.
Natamai is not only the chief, it's a person who brings about peace and amicable solutions.
Is he like that?
He's always like that.
Really? So, and is he the Natamai? Is he the boss at home or are you the
outside.
Boss? Outside. Oh, we know that. So, who is the boss at home?
Both.
Both? No, we are waiting for Sharad to answer. He's quiet.
Good evening to all. And I don't think I've been given an opportunity to speak with two women sitting over here.
No, that's why we're waiting.
Already the center stage was given to Radhika, not to me. So, that obviously is the disparity over there. And I've been sidelined actually.
No, you're not sidelined.
Yeah, okay, it's okay.
Are we sidelining him? No. Now, you tell me who is the boss. You're not...
I don't think there is any boss element in our relationship at all. There shouldn't be a boss. I think it's equality that we believe in. We give space to each other to groom ourselves and develop ourselves. So, nobody is a boss at home.
Nobody is a boss at home. So tell
maybe
me.
The children. Children.
As far as children are concerned, I am the boss.
Oh, as far as children are concerned, you are the boss. Business, who is the boss?
Business, she is the chairperson and chairman managing director of Radan Media, so she is the boss. I'm just director of operations, that company, so she's the boss.
Politics, he's the boss.
100%.
So tell me about your journey. We all know, like, you are seen as this really strong woman who climbed up the ladder, and today you are a very big entrepreneur, not just an actor. So how did that happen? It's not easy, right?
Nothing's easy. It may all look so very simple from outside. It may look very easy for people to talk about it, but it has been a very, very long and hard journey. I came into films very accidentally. Never wanted to be an actor. I was looked as an accident. My director, who saw me next door, asked me if I would act, not knowing who my father was.
Yeah. Your father is a legendary, legendary actor, Mr. M.R. Radha.
Yeah. He asked me to act, and the first thing I said, who'll see my face? And he said, that's up to me.
He's so pretty.
At that time, no. I was a 15-year-old, terrible-looking person. Anyway, it was all hormones. Coming back, of course, yeah. Accidentally, I came into movies, and I did nearly more than 350 films as a main lead. I've done a lot of movies in all the languages, from Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi. And when I started television, nobody wanted me to start. When I wanted to become an entrepreneur, I started off saying, no, let me give it a shot. And I lost very, very badly in the first round. People were cheating me, I was doing everything, and then suddenly I said, no, I'm going to corporatize the whole thing, get more professional people to work. All the experience what I had gained over the years, I put it into use, and that's how the company started. And thankfully, we've been very successful in all what we produced at that time. And the main reason why I started was, I wanted to be in control of my career. You know, we live with a lot of preconceived notions outside. When you look at an actor, and especially a woman, there's a lot of preconceived, oh, these actors, okay, after two, when she's married, that's it, nobody wants to see her. And if you have a child, you're already buried. So it's, and I was better than before in every milestone which I had, whether it was my child or anything. So then I knew it'll come to a stage where they'll ask me to play Rajinikanth's mom. And I was very adamant that I'm not going to be facing that sort of situation in my career. So that's when I started television, to be in control of my career, doing roles which I liked, and portraying women the way I wanted women to be portrayed.
Many of your colleagues have acted as Rajinikanth and Kamal Hassan's mother.
Have they? I have no idea. So anyway, so it went on like that, and that's how I'm here.
And what about you, Sharath? You started off as a producer.
No. As a newspaper boy.
Newspaper boy?
Yes. My career started as a newspaper boy, delivering newspapers in the streets of Bangalore, though I was a BSc mathematics graduate. And the first job that was offered, they told me I'm going to take care of the circulation of the newspaper. So I thought it was going to be a plum job with a table and chair sitting in. Then when I went to Bangalore, the very first job was to, the newspaper used to come from Chennai, the Tamil edition of the newspaper. So I had to beat the largest circulated Tamil newspaper in Karnataka at that point of time. And then it was a challenging job. So I had to distribute the paper, and a couple of boys don't come. Then I had to put the bundle at the back of the cycle and start moving around Bangalore, which was very cold at that point of time. And the journalistic feel and the writing capacity that I had, I thought I had. So I told the chairperson of the company that I would like to report from Bangalore. So that started my reporting career from Bangalore. And then I was selling space for the same newspaper. And then I was in between, when I had spare time, I was working in two cycle shop fitting cycles to get more money. So I can fit a cycle, break it down, and then again fit it back again. So then came films. So little money that I made, I came and produced my first film, and that is how I entered film life.
Then how did you become an actor?
I wanted to become an actor, basically, but I didn't know how to go about the whole process of coming there. So my idol in the film industry was none other than the great MGR. So I wanted to be like him, but I didn't know how to come there. So whatever character was given to me, offered to me at that point of time, I was trying. I was, of course, going to all the doorsteps of the leading producers at that point of time. And then whatever little money I made, they thought I had a lot of money. So that was one reason why they called me and spoke to me then. And then I thought I have to invest money to become an actor. That was a little worrisome to me. But that's how they looked at me. But then I produced a film first to whatever little money that I had, and the cost of production then was very, very low. I did my first film with Mr. Karthi, who was a very big actor at that point of time. Even now, he is a great actor. So we produced a film which did well, and after that, I produced another film. And later on, you know, like she said, there are ups and downs in any field that you are in. So when the downside came, then it came into acting.
Wasn't she the one who said you are a hero material?
Yeah, I was going behind a hero for a call sheet when I came to Bombay Airport, when I met Radhika and her mother there.
Oh,
and
her mother asked me. That's where your love started.
No,
it didn't start there. So it started much later. We are good friends and for a very long time. And at least I think the seed was sown on that day. That they said, I think the mother said, Sharad, you're looking smart. Why are you going behind heroes? Why don't the actors want? So later on, it did happen. Maybe that was something that she was a visionary or something. And intuitively, she said something that happened in the later years.
Absolutely. And you both are now in politics. He's been in politics for quite some time. You've been an MP. You've been with DMK, then with ADMK. You've supported many parties. Now you've joined MN.
I didn't support many parties.
I supported two parties. So now the Samatva Makkal Katchi has now joined hands with Makkal Nidhi Mayam, and your party is going to be contesting elections. How is it? Like, you both discuss politics at home, and then you decide manifesto or everything, and then how does that happen? Two politicians living under the same roof?
No. I had a different career in politics. I went about politics and I wanted to bring about a change. I had my own ideologies about politics. And so the first thing that happened was I joined DMK because there was a very big rally at that point of time to retrieve a bank which belonged to our community. Though I believe in equality, I was dragged into that basically at that point of time. And I felt, well, that bank has to be retrieved. And there was a very big rally in Chennai where I participated. And then there was a dialogue, there was a discussion. With the chief minister then was Dr. Kalinga. And there, I think the negotiations and the representation that I made impressed the leader. So then later on, he asked me to join the party, and then it was a travel with DMK. And then for various reasons, I fell out from there. And then for a shorter time, I was with ADMK, and then started my own party and moved along. And then aligned with the ADMK till about 6 months back.
Is it because of Sarath you also decided to join politics, or was there some, of course, because of your dad, you had some politics in your...
No, own. I came to politics much before Sharath. I was in 89, I was the chief campaigner for DMK, and that's when they came into power. But during my journey, I was not too keen on making it into a political career.
Yeah, I remember that because yeah.
I never joined any party as such, and I was very close to the family, so they also looked at me as Kalinga looked at me as his daughter, and so that's how it all happened, and as it went on, I was with him, I supported him, I basically admire him for his perseverance, his thoughts, his vision, and what he would like to do in politics. So I was supporting him. And then during this time, I felt because of my career, I was doing too much of television and producing and doing everything. So I said, I'll stop acting in television serials. And I said, I'll help him, support him a little bit more for this election and work with him into strengthening the party.
But you did say that Kalinga was like your dad, and you were attached to that party. But what made both of you, to join MNM, and you did not want to join hands with DMK this time?
There's a lot of other things. After DMK, of course, a short period, as I mentioned, it was ADMK for a very small time. And then we started our own party. As we went along, when she was busy, she could not spare much time. Effectively, in looking into the thing, though we do discuss politics and whatever decisions I take, she has definitely a word on that and advice on that. But we traveled along, and then after 10 years of traveling with AIADMK, I felt never have we proved ourselves, and the percentage of voting that the party has, whether it's 0.5%, 0.25%, 1%, 2%, 3%, 5%, and whatever I was used for campaigning and the entire 234 constituency, I would have at least campaigned most of the time for 164 constituencies. So that made me think, unless until Sharath Kumar has got some value, some effect on the public to get their required number of votes. So that means I definitely have some kind of a percentage. So I thought I should check it out this time. Many times we have had the thought, maybe the cadres on the Maran ready. So this time when we started, then there was a combining of forces that was happening, that, you know, dialogue, and that's when I met Kamala Haasan.
I mean, talking about politics, your movies, how is it being under the same roof? Two of you, both of you are powerful, both of you are independent, because, you know, today in marriages, there is an ego clash. So what is that works for you, that magic?
Actually, you used the right word, magic. There has never been an ego problem between both of us in our marriage.
Never?
Never. We have our arguments, we have our ups and downs, as like all marriages, on different other issues, but never on ego. If he's in the front, I'm at the back. If I'm in the front, he stands behind me. We've always been catching each other's back. So there's never been an ego issue at all. Never.
What works? What really works? What makes
because
that
work? Space. That space he respects. It's just not words. I mean, I've seen a lot of people. I've worked with, in film industry, you meet the most difficult people. And you have to deal with all crystal glass egos and stuff like that. with Sharad, from the time I met him as an actor, he was actually very, very different. He was very, very respectful. You feel very safe when you're working with him. He'll take care. And he used to be in his own world. You know, he's full of people, you know, coming to see him. And so I used to see all this when I was working with him. Then we worked together for the Kargil fundraiser. We did a very, very huge show, which he chaired. And Arvind Swami and myself were working alongside him. It's when our friendship really started. And we used to be a threesome from group, being always together. And from there on,
hung out together.
Yeah, hung out together. But we did such a huge, brilliant show. And I had nothing short of admiration for Sharad for pulling it off.
So that's when you fell for him?
Did I fall for you?
Oh my God. Did she fall for you? And she's asking now.
It's a very difficult question, who fell for who. But let's avoid that question and move along. We fell in love and we got married. I think that's
yeah. So he fell for you.
Yeah, okay, no. We'll accept it. Because this is, already I'm losing a majority in this chair here. So it's better, yeah. Accept it.
So what is it that you totally admire about Radhika? And what made you actually fall for her?
It is also, this is the same thing that she told the entire audience about me. She's a very dedicated person and very clear in her thoughts. I think sometimes even firmer than I am. And when she wants something, things done, I think her perseverance works. And she's very, her characters are very, very clear. And she doesn't mess up with words. And I'm a person, maybe I like to be nice to people. And okay,
diplomatic.
Try to...
Diplomatic.
Diplomatic, but she's very ruthless at times. So I feel she's ruthless in taking decisions where I don't think I'm ruthless. Maybe being ruthless at times, I think these days it works. I think I should change and I may change. Ruthless in the sense, not like any top leaders have been ruthless to the people. Not that, yeah.
So now you both have entered politics coming back. You've joined M&M. But if Rajinikanth had launched...
We haven't joined M&M. We have aligned.
Alliance, of course. I'm saying alliance. Yeah, I'm saying you're together with them. If Rajinikanth had launched a party, would you have forged an alliance with Mr. Rajinikanth?
Well, that's an hypothetical question. Well, since he has not started the party, if he had joined, it's not a question to be answered now. If he had joined, then what would he have done? Would have been the question to be answered. So.
No, but did you have that in mind? And
no,
what
not
did
at
you
all.
Think?
Not at
and
all.
What did you think of him suddenly moving away from?
No, if you really ask me, so two top leaders, not in the arena, and Rajini and Kamal coming. And at that point of time, I was thinking, well, the challenges were many. And that time, when we entered politics, which is much different, when both the leaders were there, now the field is a little open. And they were so-called vacuum for a charismatic leader. So maybe that was the thing that was making them to come. That's what I thought at that point of time. But definitely, they would have had their own ideas of people, how to go about the whole thing. And since he has not started the party, I don't think it's relevant to talk about what would you have done if Rajini had started the party. Maybe if the same thing, like Kamal had started a party, Rajini had started a party, and now's the time to join forces to do something different, maybe all of us would have joined.
Yeah. I somehow felt that Rajini is a wonderful person. I've done a lot of movies with him, and great regard for him. But somehow, I always felt that he would never come, is because of his health, frail health. And I don't think his, you know, he would have pushed it to that point. And I used to keep telling everybody, I used to even say, he won't come. And they would say, no, he's coming, he's announced. And well, I wish him all the best, and I really wish him the best of health. He's a fantastic, charismatic actor, and he should continue to entertain us.
Absolutely, that's what I'm sure he's taken that break for. And like during this hectic campaign, and also movie work is also going on, when you both come back home, so what is that one thing you both like to do sitting at home?
I like to relax. He has told me very strictly, I'll always keep bickering about work, but he has told me very, very strictly, no work at home once you come in. Children are there means we are not even allowed to use our cell phones on the dining table. So he is very, very particular about that. And we just relax. We are just a normal family. He loves watching all sorts of horrible movies.
Horrible movies.
You watch anything and everything.
I watch anything and everything that is there on television. I don't think anything is horrible because it's all creative.
No, do you watch her serial?
Little bit, on and off.
On and off, yeah.
And you like it?
No, gunpoint.
On and off when I see some scenes.
It's a gunpoint question.
No.
Do you like it?
I do watch them and I do appreciate her performances. And most of the films that I watch, I keep repeating those films and watching her performance. And definitely she's a person with a lot of talents. We should admit, and if you give a 10-page dialogue and between both of us, I can really admit that she will look through the dialogues and after some time read a book and chat around and giggle around where we have to go into the vanity van and sit down and learn the lines. But she would be so confident, she'll come there and she'll say the dialogues. We'll try to, you know, stand in the mirror trying to say, okay, we'll say it this way, we'll work on it. But she doesn't work. Maybe they inherited from her father. So that's only different.
You work too hard.
So I think the audience are feeling these two guys are too very serious over here and sitting and answering. Why don't you make it a little more lighter for them to know?
So while we were doing the photo shoot downstairs, Sharath was telling, we've never posed together so close even in movies.
Yep.
Why?
I don't know. We all
Running in the trees were, you know, less for us, no opportunity. So we did one or two films together.
Only one film.
Where she was a mother in one of my films. So
excuse
I'm sorry, she was
me.
Also the.
Excuse
she was also.
My,
she
you was did a dual role. I was the mother and.
The wife also. Yeah,
the wife.
Yeah, I played dual character. Sorry.
Why do you only
Small
stress
correction.
On the mother?
Small correction. Yeah.
He remembers that probably. So would you like to?
I remember he had to call me Amma in one shot, and I just stared at him and I said, "What?"
So that time you were dating?
No, we were just when great was, friends. We were great friends.
So, when did you pop that question to Radhika?
it was very casual, actually. It was in a party, I think, when a friend was having a birthday party. I went there. I was casually, she was actually walking past me. I said, hey, Radhika, will you get married to me? I said, she stared at me and just walked past. So, I don't think I impressed her that much at that point of time.
He didn't impress you then? What did you think when he walked past you? And you just
he thought it was a passing remark.
I thought he
remark.
Was pulling a fast one on me.
Okay, and one thing. I know that you both are romantic. I've heard both of you are romantic.
He is.
No. I've heard about you as well. So what I'm going to ask is, like, when you look at Sharath, one song that comes to your mind and you start humming. So Sharath is walking and then you look at him and you want to sing that song.
What would I sing it to you?
Yeah.
We can see in the misty moonlight by the flickering firelight. Any place is all right when you're
he
with
sings
me.
All this old.
Oh, please continue. Yeah. So that's the song you sing for
I can't sing to save my life. So if anybody tells you that I sang.
No, just two lines.
No, I did that to my son once. I used to hum a song, a lullaby to him. To make him sleep, and one day he looked at me and said, Ma, I'll go to sleep, but can you stop singing? So
Sharath wouldn't dare to say that, right? So
no,
two
I
lines.
Don't sing to
one
him.
Line, one line. Your photos.
me singing or her singing?
No, she will sing, then you will sing.
Oh.
What are you singing? He sings all Russian songs to me, and I thought he was BSing me. And I don't know Russian, so he must be just saying some words which I don't know. So for the longest time, I should just look at him and say, I think you're just taking me on a great ride here. So he used to sing this Russian song with full flair. And
so both of you sing that song, can
I
you?
I don't know to sing Russian.
Yeah, probably he will then.
And then one day we were in Dubai, we were in a restaurant, and there was all these Russian girls there, and then he decided to sing this song, and all these girls were like swooning over him. And I was like, wow, so he really is singing Russian.
So can you please sing that Russian song for us?
Oh my God.
I don't, both the audience anyway. I'll sing two lines for you since you asked. I got a couple of songs which I like to sing.
Oh, you look at her with full romance.
Yeah, it's a romantic song. It is, yeah, it's called Katyusha. It's a universal love song to a girl called Katyusha. Ya wo hadil tak da pahod Surovie kraya Rukois mahnula uvarod Maya lubi maya. That's
Russian.
My sweet love in Russian. Yeah.
Isn't that so beautiful? That's like really beautiful.
It is Russian.
it is, none of us know Russian.
Maya lubi maya is Russian. Yeah.
So now it's your turn. Just one line for us.
I don't sing to save my life.
No, I've heard you sing. I've definitely heard you sing in one of the interviews for him. Rosa Poo Chinna, Rosa Poo.
Yeah, that's the only song I...
Yeah, Rosa Poo Chinna, Rosa Poo. I've heard that.
Rosa Poo Chinna, Rosa Poo. Oh, God. He's swooning already.
So... when it comes to taking decisions at home, who takes the major decisions?
You're asking me or you're asking both of us?
Both of you. No, Sharad always feels my questions are to Radhika and not to him.
Yeah, because you're sitting closer to her, you always think you're asking her a question. So, anyway, basically taking decisions is, I think we consult each other in certain things, very important decisions. Definitely there's got to be some, you know, meeting point and taking decisions. It's very important. And, you know, it's the home friend or business friend or political friend, anything. I think the husband and wife should have some clear-cut understanding on what they want to do and go towards the future. I think we take decisions together.
And what about you, Radhika?
Same. I consult everything with him. We both have our favorite time is in the mornings where we sit down for a cup of coffee and we discuss everything. And we run the whole day and we all rush off to work and see each other in the evening.
So it's not just the work-life balance you both have to do. Both of you have stepchildren, stepchild. How does that occur? I mean, how do you integrate, you know, all the family members together and take them forward?
Well, we've just let it grow. It was very organic. And they've all... We don't think anybody as anything else except as children.
And you have accepted, I mean, Rayan is like your daughter. I mean, is your daughter, not
she
like.
She is my daughter, not
she
like
She adores you. I've seen so many, you know, pictures and her interviews. She adores you. That bonding, how is it for you?
It's wonderful, you know. It's basically, you know, it is love and affection, you know, just reciprocal and how you, you know. You adore people, how you respect everybody. I think Rayan from very small girl, you know, I have so much of attachment to her, like my other two daughters also. So all of them, I have three daughters and a son. So everybody has got that attachment to me. And I think I'm a friend, philosopher and guide and no mincing of words. And I love them all equally. And Rayan, of course, adores me, like you said. Yeah, so I think this is nice to have people who are, you know, look up to you for various things and when they adore you and you give the right decision, the right love and affection in the right proportions.
No, I remember the picture, Ryan's marriage picture, both of you holding each other's hand and you were sort of slightly, you rested your head on his shoulder.
And tearing
and tears.
Also. Yeah.
I can see Radhika getting
emotional.
It's an
emotion
now.
Yeah, when the girl
it
is getting married.
It was a very
married,
emotional
yeah.
moment.
I could see, I mean, she's getting emotional now and so are you. That's the beautiful bonding. And we also know that, you know, when Radhika is there in a party, she lightens up the entire place. Superbity.
Yeah, she's
right?
very talkative, yeah.
not
and very ballistically humorous, and so I think she can make everybody scream with laughter wherever she is. And something nice, you know, to make people laugh, forget their pressures, and she's one person who can do it.
That's been my motto always. I don't know, I've never liked serious movies. Although I've done maximum of films where I have to cry and roll around, I used to hate it. I love doing comedies. I love comedies. I love watching comedies. I love to laugh. I think that's the only thing we carry with us till the end is, that's my motto. I always, when I sign, I say, laugh while you can.
And but you also, you know, work really hard. But you're also a very strict boss is what I've heard.
I am. Yep.
So immediately switch over, strict boss, and then get really humorous.
Yes.
How is Sharath? He seems to be a very, very nice guy.
He's too diplomatic. He wouldn't even use a word wrong. Whenever I start talking, he'll be looking at me because he keeps saying that I might say something. He keeps saying, you're too blunt. I said, well, that's the way I am. I'm not changing.
Also, the most important advice, Sharath, that Radhika gave to you, that changed your life. Something that, you know, a decision-making moment type.
It's nothing like changing my life. I can never change. I'll be the same guy that I am. But of course, I respect her views, respect her advice. And sometimes I'm not listened to it. And at times, not listening to it has had its own issues. So I have to admit over there, yes, I think she's more a decisive person with some direction. And I value her advice. And I abide by it sometimes. Sometimes I take my own decision and take the risk and see the path. Yeah.
Okay, now you're going to have a couple game, rapid fire. Okay, so let's see. I've already met both of you individually and taken down answers. So let's start with Radhika. Okay, what's Sharath's favorite movie?
I think mostly it's MGR movies, or Rambo is his favorite movie.
No.
But he watches terrible films anyway.
No, he never mentioned Rambo.
No, because this is before I met her and after I met her, maybe. This question you should ask her. My favorite movie is one thing. Odisha Phil, John Waugh became the hero there. And then, of course, reincarnation of Peter Proud.
These are pretty old films. Much before I was in the picture.
No, but that's the answer he gave. Those were the movie names that he gave.
Yeah, I know he likes these movies.
Yeah. Tamil movie? His favorite Tamil movie?
I think it was MGR some film.
All MGR movie, that is basically, and otherwise I like Kilakachi Mele of hers.
Oh, and my Pasumbon. Movie.
Yes.
Yeah, Pasumbon.
My movie,
and
he
jeans.
Likes Kilakachi Mele.
Jeans, yeah.
Jeans and Pasumbon. Yeah. So what's Radhika's favorite movie? Very easy. You had given some five names.
Radhika's favorite movie, as well as my movies are concerned, I think she likes to watch Natpukaga. When I come into the room and she's looking glued to the television and crying, it is Natpukaga.
No, what's her favorite movie that she
watches a lot of movies. She watches serials also. She likes The Queen and so many things she watches.
She was right. She told me you're going to fail this round.
I'll tell you, he'll fail miserably. He doesn't know what I like.
I'm ignorant of that. She likes a lot.
Do you want to know?
Yeah, please.
Sound of Music.
Yeah, that of course. I took her to recently
to
Vienna
last year, before the lockdown. He took me for our wedding anniversary because I loved Sound of Music. So he said, we'll go see the places where Sound of Music was filmed. So he took me to Salzburg.
That's so beautiful. That's so romantic. So now we'll start with you. What's Sharath's favorite accessory? Look, like, Toh is a man. Like, what he likes to wear, what he likes to shop.
Clothes, but watch, his Mont Blanc, what's those bags you have?
You're right. Watch, he gave a list, perfumes, shoes.
Oh my God, perfumes, yeah, oh God. How did I miss that? Yeah, we've got a full cupboard full of perfumes. And he keeps saying, somebody is stealing my perfumes.
Somebody is stealing your perfumes? Who is it? Is it you?
No.
Why would I wear it?
You wouldn't even try.
I don't even open it.
So what's Radhika's favorite accessory that she likes to wear?
He'll fail.
No, jewelry, of course, And of course, she likes everything. She likes bags. Bags.
Bags, when she told me, she said nothing.
Why women keep on buying bags? I don't understand. You know, so many bags they'll be having at home.
Really?
Anything and everything they like to buy, and so they'll buy it.
So now, to both, you know, I know I'm, both of you are going to, you know, get this answer
I
right.
I think the audience are getting bored a little.
No, they're not getting bored. Your favorite holiday destination.
Aren't we boring you sitting in front there with a political question that you're firing away?
No, they're enjoying. Favorite holiday destination.
Mostly UK and Edinburgh, and we just like to travel.
That's right. And also, what Radhika hates at home, you know, like creepy lizards,
yeah. Mostly lizards, they have to kill it. But you
she
know,
hates
I,
lizards.
I don't like killing lizards because
no, she hates
I get
lizards.
Unnerved by them. She hates lizards, cockroaches, and snakes.
She told.
And something which ran in the house.
Rats.
You helped him to get this right.
Yeah, because we were in a restaurant.
No, it's not a regular affair.
I saw
a
rat. I was on top of the dining table.
You were on top of the dining table.
Yeah, in a 5-star restaurant, newly opened. So she saw a rat. She was on top of the dining table. She thought that was going to be in the plate later.
So what does he hate?
He just hates indiscipline. Indiscipline. He is such a stickler for timing and just for him, everything has to go his way, my way, and that's my way.
Yeah, I mean, for her.
For
what
her
she way. Hates. What she hates.
Lying.
Oh, 100%. I cannot deal with lying.
You cannot. And one irritating thing about Sharad.
Oh God, his clothes.
Loads. Loads.
No, when he gets ready, it's about 100.
Oh, that way. I thought my clothes are irritating.
Chairs, what you hate about?
Which he'll try on and it'll be on the floor and I'm the one who has to pick it up.
Oh my God. So that's the most irritating part. For you?
No.
Nothing. You have to go back home.
Nothing. Nothing irritates me. Except her mood swings. You know, like when she walks up the staircase, I know she's in a different mood. So I hate that.
And I heard you're a very romantic person. So the most romantic thing you have ever done for her?
The most romantic thing, I would say, I'm sorry, I'm not coming back tonight and I'll see you tomorrow morning. And then I'll ask somebody to knock the door and leave a bunch of flowers over there. And they'll ask who sent it. Then I'll just walk in and say, this is me. She'll be surprised. So surprises I like sometimes. That's what I like.
Radhika, how do you enjoy that or... No, she doesn't enjoy that.
She doesn't like surprises.
I hate surprises.
Surprises, she hates singing that, you know, that is one
And you
thing.
Continue to give her surprises.
Yeah.
So what do you do when you look at him with this bunch of flowers standing outside at 2 a.m.?
Yeah, I'll be like, what are you doing? Why did you lie to me?
Oh, so she only questions about why you lied to me. So what's the romantic thing Radhika has done for you?
It's getting too personal now. Yeah, okay. Romantic thing, a lot of things, yes. Mm. She, of course, she wherever she goes, she'll think of me, buying clothes for me. That's romantic, I think. Whenever she goes for shopping, I don't know why she picks up shirts for me, why she's thinking about me. That's something sweet, you know. Normally, not every guy is going to think when he's going shopping to think about the woman to buy back things. I don't know. But she does that, yes.
What about cook for you?
Yeah, cooking is different. She's not asking about.
Tell.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, she's you know, like goading me into telling me things. Yeah, she cooks very well, like me.
During the COVID, he cooked for me.
What did you do?
Clean the kitchen, which is the worst thing to do.
No, we did a lot of things.
So, is he a decent cook? I know you're a very good baker. You know, I've heard about your baking skills. How does Sharad cook, and what's his favorite food?
Oh my God, his is like a. Like going to the parliament. Full preparation will be there. He will put down a list. Then he will put everything in the kitchen on a table. Then he will measure everything. Then he will set the vessels in order. And then he will start cutting. And then he will use about 6 vessels to make one dish. And we'll have to just stand there watching him and say, yes, fantastic. Good job.
It is the result that matters.
So result is good, right?
Result is always good.
Absolutely. That's like super fun. I think he won hands down.
Did he?
Yeah, he did. He almost said, you know, answered everything.
Congratulations.
And he also has done, you know, he's impressed you in so many ways.
Yes, he has.
Yeah. And finally, our final question is, As a couple, what is your ambition for yourselves, for your children and the society? Both of you.
For the society or for ourselves?
Everything, both.
Generally, I think we have to, you know, a lot of love and affection, like to, you know, be happy and try to make the society happy in whatever way you can, and take care of people who are, you know, unfortunate. And that's what we would think of. I think whatever God has given us, and try to distribute it in whatever which we can, and bring out the happiness in the people's faces. So that's what I think is the best thing to do for people who have become celebrities or people who have become affluent, and they can share whatever they got. I think in Bible, and if we can say Quran, or even the scriptures of the Tamil scriptures, if a man has been given a lot of wealth, I think it is to be shared with others. Oh. I think that is what I believe
and
in.
And personally,
I think,
for you?
We are a very close-knit family, and we like to be that way. We just want us to grow together like that.
Thank you.
We value every day, grateful every day for what we have, which so many other people don't have. And Sharat is basically a giver. He loves to do so much for society, so much for people, so many things. I've been very supportive in that. And being celebrities, personalities, I think we should do a bit for society. Just not being armchair politics and armchair commentators. We would like to be part of the mainstream change.
That's so beautifully said. Thank you so much, both
Thank
of you, for joining us. Before you leave, just for 1 minute, a dance, a couple dance.
No, sorry. No.
Just
it becomes more of, I don't think I like to dance or...
No, she will dance. She is a party
she will
person.
Dance. She's a good dancer.
Yeah.
I,
just music,
that I
please.
Like, you know,
1 minute.
I would like Rajdeep to ask me some question if you want. That would be much better than
no,
to
we are wrapping
dance
up
over
session.
Here.
Just a minute.
Yeah, Radhika can dance. I'm sorry. I'm a very bad dancer.
Oh. Okay. One song. 1 minute. That's it. And Sharat, you're such a romantic person. You have given so many surprises and she totally loves it. Come on.
I never expected this in India today, yes. Enclave for me to come and dance over here. I thought I'm going to interact with some
we
people
have
over here.
Very good interaction, and now it's just 1 minute of dance. That's it. One more. Yes, music, please.
I hope people don't go off.
Nobody. We have watched your movies.
என்ன சொல்லி என்னை சொல்ல காதல் என்னை கையால்
Thank you very much, Radhika Sharat. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.